You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about Azure Machine Learning Service data sets. Imagine being able to know exactly where your model came from, how it was built, and what data is in it. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to talk about something called a data set. I have with me my colleague May. Tell us who you are and what you do, my friend.
My name is May. I'm a PM working in Microsoft, and the product I'm working on is Azure Machine Learning Datasets.
Fantastic. So why don't you tell us what datasets are?
Sure. Dataset is an asset in your machine learning workspace where we help you connect to your to the data in your storage service and make the data available for your machine learning experiments.
So when you say asset, it's basically, I mean, are we copying data? Does it cost more? What's going on there?
No, so by creating a data set, you just create a reference to the data in your storage service. We do not copy your data, so there's no storage cost incurred when you create a data set.
So when you're using a data set, it's basically like a pointer to some other data that's stored on storage. Did I get that right?
Exactly.
So why would you do that? Why would you make a data set if you could just point it directly to storage?
Well, first, we make it easy for you to access your data. What you only need to register data once, and then you can reuse it across different experiments or share it with your colleagues. Second, we integrate well with our training products. You can use data sets as a direct input for your script run, Azure machine learning pipelines, and automated machine learning. And third, we help you check where data has been used. For each experiment run, you will be able to see, oh, this is the input data set I use for this experiment. And you can also even register the data set with your models so that users will be able to know, okay, this model was trained by this data set for reproducibility and audit purpose.
So let me see if I understand. There was three reasons you said. The first one is because it's a shareable asset that anyone can use.
Yes.
The second one is because it's easy to put into experimentation.
Uh-huh.
And the last one was this thing of being able to trace where the data set's been used.
Exactly.
Okay, so let's start first, because I wanted to see how you actually use this. So let's first start with how do you create a data set,
uh-huh.
Number one, and number two, how do you use it? Can you show us?
Sure, definitely.
All right, let's do it.
So I'm in my machine learning workspace,
okay.
And we have data sets under assets. You can create data set from either local files, from your data storage, or your web URLs.
So let me pause right there. So when you say, let's go back to that little drop down here. So when you say create data set,
mm-hmm.
So from local files is basically I can upload stuff.
Yes, exactly.
Okay. From a data store is if I already have a storage that I've mapped to my Azure Machine Learning account. Did I get that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so far I'm 2 for 3. I'm not sure what it means by web files. Why don't you describe what that is?
Oh, web files is just you can paste the URLs, like for public data, for example, right? You can paste the URLs that of the data to create the data
set. I see. And does it pull it down and put it somewhere for you?
No, we just record that as a pointer, and when you use the data set, we will help you load the data from the web.
That's pretty cool. So mm-hmm. in essence, it's like if there's a public Kaggle data set or some other data set, you can have a web reference directly to that CSV file and it'll download it.
Exactly.
Fantastic. All right, sorry, I interrupted you. Let's make one.
Sure, I'll use from my data store. So these are all the storage container I have. I will use the workspace default Azure blob here. And then if I click Browse, it will show all the files available in my blob storage. And by creating a data set, you can either point to a single CSV files or our full folders, so which means multiple files. So in this case, I'll just point to these folders.
I see. Each CSV file has the same tabular structure.
Exactly, same schema.
And before you go to save, so when you pointed it to data stores, that's the mapping of the actual Azure storage to the machine learning workspace, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
So I'll click save and give my data set a name. When I click next, it will try to parse my data into a tabular format and will help like detect the file format, delimiters, column headers all for you. And these are the first few rows of my data. And if I click next, this is the schema of my data, and I can choose to drop a few columns that's not relevant for my experiments.
I see.
Or I can change the column type if I want. Then after that, I will click down. So then this data set will show up in my machine learning workspace.
Got it. And so now that asset is shareable across anyone that's in the workspace.
Exactly.
That's awesome. And this feels like almost like using pandas, but storing all the stuff in the actual workspace. Is that right?
Exactly.
Cool. All right. So how do you use it? Oh, well, you were going to show us something here.
So this is the overview page of the dataset I just created. As for how do I use it, so there are two ways to consume your dataset. The mm-hmm. first way is to consume it directly. So here are the sample code. You can load your, like, after you get your dataset by name from the workspace object, you can load it into common data frames like pandas or Spark, and then data scientists can kind of continue their data preparation or feature engineering using the libraries that they're already very familiar with.
And that's really cool because it actually puts in your sub ID and resource group and everything, so your workspace is already, you can just literally copy this code and put it into your notebook.
Exactly. Right? So that's the first way to consume it. The second way is more for deep learning scenarios where a data frame doesn't really make much sense.
Right.
So data sets help you mount your data from your storage service to the remote compute.
Right.
And I can show you a demo.
Let's do that. Because as you're getting the tab open, like, I'm a computer vision guy. Mm-hmm. I love computer vision. And it's like, you don't want to copy all of the images into the container, right?
Exactly.
You want to somehow mount it. So I'm interested to see how that's done with data sets.
Sure. So here I'm loading my data set from Azure ML Open Datasets. I'm using Amnest here. And I will register this Amnest dataset with my workspace. By clicking that, this Amnest dataset will actually show up in my workspace.
Oh, so you created a dataset in code this time?
Yes.
Got it, cool.
So by registering, it will just show up in the list. So Amnest dataset here.
Cool.
So here, I'm going to do some data exploration. And so what I will do is to mount my Amnest dataset to my notebook VMs. So again, we don't copy your data. Your data stays in the blob storage. And here is just to mount the data to the notebook VM so that we can take a look at, like, a few sample files.
I see. So this, so when you're calling Amnest dataset mount, you're mounting it to a path in the container, but it's not copying the files over?
No, it's just mounted.
Got it. Cool.
So so these are the, like, sample images and labels. It all looks good. And now I'm going to start, like, configure training.
Cool.
So I will first get my dataset back from the workspace by name. And dataset.toPath kind of shows you what are the files available pointed by your dataset.
That's cool.
And then here I'm configuring my TensorFlow estimators. And the one thing I want to highlight here is how you use dataset as the input. So you can call dataset.sNameInput as mount. This basically tells to mount my Amnest dataset to this compute target.
Got it.
And this is my training script. It shows you how to get your data. So as you can remember, we use it. We pass the dataset in as an argument, mm-hmm. and in your training script, you will get this data folder back, and it basically points to the pointed mounted path on your remote compute.
So if I remember right, this is actually running inside of a remote compute inside of a container.
Yes.
And so basically, when you say the data folder, it thinks it's just a local file on the container, when in reality, the subsystem is mounted as a share.
Exactly.
Got it,
exactly.
Cool.
So that for data scientists, they don't really need to change a single line of code in their training script when they switch from local training to remote training.
That's cool.
Yep. So you can just load your data as if a local path.
That's cool.
So after all this configuration, you can just submit the rounds, and you will be able to see the experiments from your workspace.
Mm-hmm.
And this was the experiment I submitted just now. And if you go to the round detail page, we have input datasets as saved as one properties. So this is where we help you trace which dataset was used for the round.
And so that is what it's called data lineage. For example, so when you run something, obviously the model is produced. In the model, you can point back to the experiment that made it, and then you can point back to the actual dataset you use as well. Is that
yes.
Right?
So if you click this link, it will link you back to the Amnest dataset.
Got
so
it.
You know, like, this was the dataset that I used for this training. As for your questions about models, you can actually register a model with the dataset directly. So I will just run the register model, register my model with my training dataset.
Mm-hmm.
And if I do that, under Amnest dataset, you will see a model tab. which lists all the models that has used this MNIST datasets.
And that's really cool because generally, I don't know, when I do machine learning, I just run the thing and export the model. But now if you do this in the context of Azure Machine Learning Service, you're able to trace the model to the experiment, to the data set as well, which
exactly.
is really cool.
Yes.
That's awesome. Well, where can people go to find out more about this?
So you can find out more documentation about data sets in our Azure Machine Learning documentation website. And we have lots of sample notebook in our GitHub repo.
Fantastic.
As well.
We'll put some links below so you can take a look at those. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us.
Thank you, Seth.
Thank you so much for watching. We've learned all about how to use data sets in Azure Machine Learning Service Workspace. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.